man. Oh, who this? Hello? Who this? Samsung. Look, man, I gotta be honest. I am very, very disappointed with you. What you mean, why? Man, my accessory game. I got the one case out of two, meaning I didn't get my second case. And by this time, I'd already moved on to a D-brand skin, so I don't even need the case. That's right, I'm rocking my phone naked with this new Robo Camo skin. You baited me in with the $600 off trade-in, which I can't lie, I was actually super, super duper fly. I wanted my phone with my free accessories at the same time, and you did not deliver. I'm sick of this, man. Oh, shit. Hello, Tim Apple. Hey, you slick, sly player, you. I saw what you did because you know everybody's stuck in their house on quarantine. So you're going to drop the iPad Pro so they can have, you know, they need something to get on with. I see you playing, right, right. I thought we had an arrangement. You supposed to be giving me the tea. There's no March event and y'all going to sneak that joint out on everybody with the MacBook Air. But I'll have a conversation with you about that MacBook Air. Yeah, I ordered one. You know what I mean? You ain't sending me one. But how about you send me that new Super Fire keyboard with the trackpad that come out in May? You're not gonna send it. That's right, y'all. Today we have in the Galaxy Note 10 Plus versus the Samsung S20 Plus. Which one is really king? In this video, it's about to go down. If you love your Galaxy Note 10 Plus, smash that like button right now because the Note 10 Plus is king. But if you love your Samsung Galaxy S20 Plus, smash that like button as well because the S20 Plus is absolute fire. But which one is better? Is there even a clear winner? And which one should you buy? I will answer all of these questions and more by the end of this video. First thing first, let's get into the physical differences and technical specs. As far as sizing goes, they're practically the same size, but the Note 10 Plus has a slight edge with that cornered box shape, as opposed to the S20 Plus, which just has this rounded design. So really it just comes down to preference between the two. I will admit that the rounded edges on the S20 Plus is nicer in the hand, but the box shape of the Note 10 Plus adds to that traditional feel of a rectangular display. Now, when we talk about weight, the weight goes to the S20 Plus weighing in at 186 grams, while the Note 10 Plus weighs in at 196 grams. Not a big enough difference at all between the two. Now, when we talk about display, we got a 6.7 inch AMOLED display on the S20 Plus versus a 6.8 inch AMOLED on the Note 10 Plus. It's really hard to tell these displays apart or which is better, although on paper, the S20 Plus has a denser PPI at 525 pixels per inch versus the Note 10 8 at 498 pixels per inch. But as you can see, I have them side by side watching the exact same content and both look amazing. So you don't lose in display either way you go, except for the 120 hertz refresh rate. Now, this is where the S20 Plus has an advantage. And to be honest, it's a noticeable advantage, but not a decision maker. Like, you won't feel cheated if you choose the Note 10 Plus over the S20 Plus just because of a 120 hertz refresh rate, but it is absolutely butter. Now, as far as processor, we're talking Snapdragon 865 on the S20 Plus versus the 855 on the Note 10 Plus. Will you feel left behind on the Note 10? No. 5G isn't really a thing yet. Speed is there, snappiness is there. Now, if 5G was actual a thing, this would probably be a different conversation. Now, when it comes to storage and RAM, there's no real advantage between the two. And reason being is that they both have 12 gigabytes of RAM. And storage is always expandable on flagship Galaxy devices. So you can always have an affordable option of expanding your memory. Just get you one of the micro SD joints for the low low. Now, battery. As far as battery goes, you get 4,500 milliamp hours on the S20 Plus versus 4,300 milliamp hours on the Note 10 Plus, which again, isn't much of a difference. I can make it through my day with both devices. I'm in 120 hertz full HD Plus on the Galaxy S20 Plus, which drains battery more, as does using the quad HD resolution on the Note 10 Plus. Now, if you want to improve either of these devices, you drop down to just 60 hertz full HD and neglect the amazing displays that you were given and that you paid for. So why would I do that? I'm not. And fun fact, this is how all Samsung devices are shipped to you. So do yourself a favor, go into display settings and take advantage of the display you paid for. Yes, it'll drain more battery, but You literally pay for these displays features, so why not use them? Now, water resistance between the two is exactly the same, no difference there, but color selection is different between the two. Now, in the Note 10 Plus, you're offered Aura Blue, Aura Black, Aura White, and the infamous Aura Glow. On the S20 Plus, you only get the Cosmic Gray, the Cosmic Black. You get this Fire Cloud Blue, which is covered up with the skin right now. Then there's even more Fire Aura Blue, which is a Best Buy exclusive. Now, as far as pricing goes, brand new, they are in the same arena at around $1,200 for the S20 Plus before any discounts or trade-in values, and the Note 10 Plus at around $1,100 brand new before any discounts or trade-in values. Now, we all know on the secondhand market, a used Note 10 Plus in great condition can be bought for well under this. But if you choose to go brand new, the price difference isn't much between the two. And I'm sure there are deals all over the place for both of them. Now let's get into cameras. Then after that, we'll talk user experience, which is most important. And then I'll give a brutally honest conclusion that'll answer a lot of the questions you all have. As far as cameras go, on papers, there are just a few differences spec-wise. Like, both have the 12 megapixel main rear camera sensor, but the S20 Plus has a 64 megapixel telephoto sensor versus the Note 10 Plus's 12 megapixel telephoto sensor. So zooming on here is gonna be better. But on the other hand, the Note 10 Plus has a 16 millimeter ultra-wide sensor versus the S20 Plus's 12 megapixel ultra-wide sensor. Both feature a time-of-flight sensor on the rear and a 10 megapixel selfie camera on the front. As far as video capability goes, the only difference is that the S20 Plus can do up to 8K video at 30 frames per second, while the Note 10 Plus caps out at 4K 60, which, if we are all being honest, that's the most you'll practically use as 4K 60 in the discussion. Who got an 8K monitor? I'm waiting. So I did take a photo of the exact same object in the exact same setting with both, and you can see the results for yourself. But those of you who know me, I'm always tougher on Samsung's camera ability because I think it can always be better. It's good enough, and mostly everyone will enjoy the results whether using the S20 Plus or the Note 10 Plus, and that's the short version. I'll probably do a more in-depth camera comparison soon once the weather allows me. It's raining out there, player. Here we go, user experience. The most important thing is user experience. It's what you experience whenever you use either of these devices. So here's the raw truth. Using either one of these devices is great, but there are some key differences, like the 120 hertz display, for instance. You do notice a smoother interaction with your smartphone when doing everyday tasks, and it's pleasing to use. I love it. But there's a key thing that you can never have on the S20 Plus, and that is, drum roll, the S Pen. This very accessory, which I missed the hole, but I got it in there, player. This very accessory separates the two in experience, features, and usability. The S Pen is the mouse to the everyday smartphone workhorse. The Note device paired with this S Pen is the business companion as well as a creative's best friend. Now, beyond these two separating features, you're getting the almost exact same user experience. Best displays in a smartphone in the game, period, don't at me. Some of the most feature-packed smartphones on the market. Samsung's clean One UI experience and just overall really great smartphones. In conclusion, do you need and will you use the infamous S Pen? Is the 120 hertz display a must for you? Do you want to save a nice amount of money and go secondhand, or should you just wait for the Note 20? My number one answer in this question is you probably should wait to see what the Note 20 will offer, as it's not really that far away. Well, all right, it is a ways away. So if you absolutely can't wait, I'm a Note 10 Plus user through and through, but that's me. I actually utilize the S Pen, making the Note 10 Plus the better fit for me. But if you won't utilize the S Pen and can benefit from the 120 hertz display, you know, a little later tech and so forth, and the latest release, the S20 Plus is probably the better fit for you. And be honest with yourself in regards to the S Pen, because most of you won't use it enough to warrant even having it. That's why once a Note user, always a Note user. My name is CJ, this is CJ Knows Tech, where I know tech, so you don't have to. And I hope I just made your decision easier, player. All right, so I just wanna add in this freestyle, like, thought and opinion, and just like brutally honest truth with these phones. they're both great. They both look good. They both perform extremely well. Now, I love Galaxy Notes because of that S Pen. I use the S Pen religiously. It's so dope. I mean, it's like having a mouse. Like, as you hover over the screen, you have a pointer there. And when you hover over things that have actions, like a link and, you know what I mean? Those actions happen. Hovering over your gallery and having your picture get bigger and things like that. And all around having that precision with the S Pen, especially for typing and things like that, where your finger isn't as accurate, those things like trump a lot for me as far as the S20 Plus user experience goes. But to be honest, just the everyday practical, typical smartphone experience, the S20 Plus is fire. Like that 120 Hertz display really makes a difference. But just all in all, you know, I'm really impressed with the zoom in picture quality, especially at like 4X. 4X is a sweet spot. 10X is fair, but 4X is like fire. And I'm pretty sure that's due to the 64 megapixel telephoto in here. The video performance is actually really good and impressive. You can create decent video content on both of these devices. Like, a lot of the points I hit on in this video are just spot on as far as, you know, the user experience between the two. It's not a this one is better than that one. It's like, which one is really best for you? And that's what it really comes down to. For me, the Galaxy Note devices are the better choice, which is why personally, I would wait for the Note 20 if I was shopping right now. But like, you know, I get every Note. So it's hard for me to imagine me not getting a Note and having to wait for the next one, you know, or decide this type of decision. You know, this one's nicer in the pocket because of the rounded edges. It makes a difference. It's crazy. This one in the pocket, you kind of got those cornered edges, and big smartphones in the front pocket, the shape and the weight matters. Both are fine in the pocket, but this one's better. My user experience between the two is very similar. Like I said, the only deciding factor is the S Pen. So that's really the deciding factor in this decision. No 20 all day, player Samsung, give me a call. Who this? Hello? Who this? Man, Samsung, I don't want your apology, player. You know what the Z Flip do, right? You damn right I want to be there for the Note 20 event. That's the best event of all. But if you ain't giving me that early, you know, embargo access, blessing your boy with, you know, a unit to get out here early to my people, because I do have one of the largest Note fan bases. I don't even want to, what, huh? Maybe? What does maybe mean? Hey, look, let me show you something, man. This is why I love the Z Flip.
I won't stop.